Now let's talk about the available energy referred to a cycle. Alright, so let us look at this diagram. Now this diagram indicates a cyclic heat engine, okay, which is working between two temperature reservoirs at T1 and T2, and we assume that T1 is higher than T2. Now we have defined that what is available energy. Now, available energy is basically the available part of the energy supplied that can be converted into useful high grade energy. Now, if you define available energy in context of this cyclic heat engine, we can say that it is the maximum work output obtainable from a certain heat input in a cyclic heat engine. Okay, let me write this down and then we will look at it. So available energy, okay, it is the maximum work obtainable or work output, okay, maximum work obtainable from a certain heat input, Now this word certain is very, very important. Okay, because when you change your heat input or the amount of heat input, your available energy part will also change. Okay, because proportionately your work output will change. You put in more energy, you get more work output, let us say. And when you put in low energy or less energy, you get, let us say, less work output. So this is in proportion. So that is why we use a certain heat input. So this is not a generalized statement. Okay, and it is pertaining to a certain value of heat input. So from a certain heat input to a cyclic heat engine. So if you look at this, now figure again. Play this figure again. It has some heat input, you know, as Q1, then it has some work output as W, and it has some heat rejection as Q2. Now we can say that Q1 is the heat input, or that certain heat input. Okay, so this is the certain heat input. Okay, and let us say corresponding to this heat input, this is the maximum amount of work output that I'm getting. So maximum work output means that this is the available energy. Alright, and then you have some heat rejection. Now this heat rejection is basically the part of this heat input that is not converted into work. So this becomes my unavailable energy, or UE. So now we can differentiate. Okay, so I can say that in a cyclic heat engine, the work output or the maximum work output is my available energy, and the heat rejected is the unavailable energy. Okay, so if you look at this schematic again, input is equal to the work output plus the heat rejection. So you can write it down like this, that Q1 is equal to available energy plus unavailable energy, because this is analogous to Q1 is equal to W max plus Q2. All right, and we can say that W max is equal to Q1 minus Q2. Isn't it? And this is equal to Q1 minus unavailable energy. So this is a very important relation to understand and note down. Now, because it is working under two temperature limits, T1, T2, and it's a cyclic heat engine, okay, and we can say that the efficiency of a reversible heat engine is 1 minus T2 upon T1. It is 1 minus T2 upon T1. Now, if you look at this expression, let's analyze this expression for a moment. Okay, I need to increase my efficiency. Now, how do I increase my efficiency? Okay, now when you keep the value of the input temperature Okay, so T1 is the input temperature, or the temperature at which the heat is supplied. So let us define it first. Okay, so T1 is the temperature at which heat is supplied. Okay, so let us say this is a constant value. So for a fixed value of T1, if I have to increase the efficiency, we will have to decrease the heat at which the heat is rejected, that is T2. Okay, so let's write it down mathematically. So for this to be constant, okay, for increment of the efficiency, we'll have to decrease T2. Now, the lowest practicable temperature of heat rejection, because at the lowest temperature of heat rejection, you would have the maximum possible efficiency at a constant value of T1. Right, you should listen to these words carefully. Okay, so I can say that at lowest practical value of T2, okay, at a constant, or you can say with a fixed or with a constant, with a constant value of T1, all right, efficiency of reversible cyclic heat engine would be a maximum value. Okay, and this lowest practicable value of T2, this has a special name and a special symbol, and the special symbol is T0. So the lowest practical value of T2 is basically T0, which is also known as the temperature of surroundings. Okay, so this is the temperature of surrounding. So the surrounding temperature is basically the lowest practicable temperature at which heat can be rejected, and you will have the maximum value of your efficiency, temperature of surroundings. Alright, so if you rewrite the equation, so this would become eta reversible maximum, this is equal to 1 minus, now T2 becomes T0 upon T1. Where T0 is the temperature of surroundings. Okay, now because it's the maximum efficiency, I can say this is equal to the maximum work output upon a fixed value of Q1, because if T1 is a constant value, the heat input will also be a constant value, it cannot change. Okay, so I can say, or I can write down, that maximum work output is equal to 1 minus T0 upon T1 into Q1. So this is something that you should note down. Alright, so now, you know, before we move forward, let's go back to the diagram on the top. So initially we were looking at this diagram, now let's focus on this diagram. That's a plot between temperature and entropy. Now in this plot, let us take a finite process xy. So this is the process xy, and in this process we are supplying heat reversibly to a heat engine, right? Now for that matter of fact, let's take an elementary cycle. So let's take a small cycle like this. Okay, let's make it green in color, and let's supply heat at a constant temperature, because let us say this temperature is T1. So I am supplying heat at temperature T1, which is TQ1, because it's a elementary cycle. Okay, and corresponding to this DQ1, I get the work output as DW max. Okay, so if you go back to the bottom of the screen and rewrite this for this elementary cycle, I would get dW max is equal to 1 minus T naught by T1 into dQ1. Okay, and this will be rewritten in the form of dQ1 minus T naught by T1 into dQ1. Okay, and because this is equal to maximum work developed at a constant heat input or at a certain heat input, this is equal to the available energy. So the formula for available energy is now this, and this is for a elementary heat engine cycle. Now if you integrate this for the whole cycle, okay, for the whole process I would say, then you would get integral from x to y, and this is the maximum possible work, okay, and this is equal to integral again from x to y, you'll get d dash q1 minus integral again from x to y, you get t naught upon t1 into d dash q1. Okay, now this upon integration would become W max, which is equal to the available energy, isn't it? And this is equal to the integral for this would be Q from X to Y, because it's a path dependent function, minus. Now, if you integrate this part, okay, T naught is constant. This is equal to dS1, because the heat that we are supplying is reversible, and dQ reversible upon temperature is entropy, isn't it? So this becomes dS1, and this would become SY minus SX. So this is an expression for finding out the mathematical value of available energy. Okay, that is QXY, that is in between two states, minus T naught, that is the temperature of the surroundings, into the difference of entropy between the two states. Okay, now if I have to find out the value of unavailable energy, and we know that this is equal to the heat supplied, which is QXY in this case, minus the maximum work output, isn't it? And this is equal to T naught into SY minus SX. So basically, if you look at this particular equation, this is the heat supplied and this part is the unavailable energy. Okay, so I hope you understood this, mathematical analysis. Now, if you go back to the graph on top of the screen here, and let us draw a temperature. So this is the temperature at which, let us say, heat is being added into this elementary cycle. So for the whole process, let me get rid of it. So let me put a blue color over here. So let us say, in going from x to y, the heat input is QXY. Okay, so this is how the process is proceeding. Now let me define a temperature T naught. So T naught is the minimum temperature of heat rejection for maximum work output. Now, at this point, the entropy is SX, and at this point, the entropy is SY. Okay, so you have a certain amount of area over here. So this is the area that you get. Okay, and on top you have some area. And let me use some other color, this area. Alright, so this is the area. So this is one part of the graph, that is up till T naught, and this is the second part of the graph, which is below T naught. Okay, if you look at this, this is the maximum work output and this is the available energy. And if you find out the area of this rectangle, okay, this is what? this is T naught, and the value for this is Sy minus Sx, which is Sy minus Sx. So the area of this is T naught into this value, which is nothing but unavailable energy. So this is how you can, you can describe, or you can plot, or you can denote available energy and unavailable energy on a graph, which is a TS plot. Okay, so I sincerely hope that you are able to understand the application of available energy referred to a cycle. Okay, and you need to remember this equation and this equation and the concept of the temperature of surroundings. So after this understanding, let's move forward and talk about the decrease in available energy when heat is transferred through a finite temperature difference.